Questions people are asking about Dream Chaser. The spacecraft was once considered a strong competitor to SpaceX Starliner and Dragon. However, the spacecraft has been plagued by delays and problems. Despite high hopes, it has yet to take off. What's causing these problems? Could Dream Chaser end up being NASA's next big disappointment? Let's talk more on today's episode of NR Studio. The retirement of the space shuttle marks the end of a significant era in American spaceflight, creating a major gap in the country's ability to fly in space. For more than a decade, SpaceX Dragon has been primarily responsible for ferrying cargo and crew to the International Space Station. Fortunately, Dragon has risen to the challenge and shown that it is a reliable and affordable vehicle. Many still want the flexibility and graceful landings of a shuttle-style spacecraft. That dream continues with Dream Chaser, a winged spacecraft built by Sierra Space. Dream Chaser is designed to take off on a regular rocket and glide back to Earth, landing on a runway. Its ability to carry cargo and crew to the ISS and future space stations has made it a highly anticipated new member of America's growing fleet of spacecraft. However, Dream Chaser has yet to fly. Its first launch has been delayed multiple times, and years have passed since its original launch date. What's stopping it? The main problem is that its launch vehicle, the ULA-built Vulcan Centaur, is behind schedule. Dream Chaser was originally scheduled to fly on Vulcan's second mission, but that mission has been delayed several times. Vulcan's first flight was delayed for several years and finally took place in January 2024. The delays caused problems and made Dream Chaser's development even longer. In November 2023, Sierra Space completed the first flight-ready Dream Chaser, called Tenacity. At the time, the spacecraft was scheduled to fly in April of last year. Although Vulcan is ready to fly, Dream Chaser needs more time for testing. Testing has gone well, but it's taken longer than we thought. At the same time, Vulcan has its own challenges to overcome. ULA is working hard to get national security certification so it can compete for government and military contracts. This market is increasingly being taken over by SpaceX. To achieve this goal, ULA has decided to focus on a second Vulcan mission in October 2024 that will carry a test payload instead of Dream Chaser. Ironically, at the time, Dream Chaser seemed ready. However, Vulcan did not have the right equipment or launch time available to it. To make matters worse, Vulcan was having problems with its solid rocket boosters. These issues have prevented it from launching its third mission, leaving Dream Chaser stuck on the ground even longer. Even if Vulcan is ready to go, we still can't predict when Dream Chaser will launch. Vulcan is expected to carry a lot of delayed military cargo from previous years as part of the Space Force's Phase 2 National Security Space Launch Program. Additionally, it has been hired to assist Amazon's Kuiper Satellite Group, approving at least 18 launches. As a result, Dream Chaser has struggled to find launch time. The main problem stems from the risky partnership between two slow systems. Dream Chaser and Vulcan are both new projects with bold goals and tight schedules, but Vulcan's development has taken precedence over national security needs. Vulcan can't wait to see Dream Chaser, but it still lacks the speed needed for flexibility. These scheduling and planning issues have delayed Dream Chaser's first flight and cast doubt on its future success. The spacecraft is designed to be more than just a single prototype. Sierra Space has plans for a second cargo version called Reverence, and after that, they'll build a version that can carry astronauts. Each delay pushes those future goals further away. That makes Dream Chaser's first mission especially important. Whether it launches in 2025 or later, it will show what the spacecraft can do and help determine whether it can be used to carry cargo and crew. NASA currently uses three spacecraft to assist the ISS: SpaceX Dragon, Boeing Starliner, and Northrop Grumman's Cygnus. Dragon has been very reliable and has completed many missions to transport crude oil and cargo. On the other hand, Starliner has had some issues. Since its first cargo flight in 2022, every mission since, including the recent CFT-1 crude oil mission, has had technical issues. The spacecraft is unlikely to fly again until early 2026. Cygnus has had issues with its hardware, especially during the NG-22 mission, which has delayed its launch schedule. This puts NASA in a difficult position, relying too much on Dragon and looking for other options. Dream Chaser could play a vital role in NASA's fleet. It can land on runways, has a flexible design, and can adapt to a variety of missions, providing specific benefits. However, continued delays are hurting the chances for Sierra Space and the ISS. NASA planned budget cuts could lead to fewer missions to the ISS. If that happens, Dragon will likely remain the primary focus, reducing the chances for Dream Chaser to show its capabilities. Dream Chaser is intended to be used not only for the ISS, but also for future commercial space stations like Orbital Reef, which is being developed by Blue Origin and Sierra Space. But with its progress slow, the pressure is now even higher to get it flying. In short, Dream Chaser shows promise, but its future is uncertain. Delays from Sierra Space and ULA have raised concerns. A successful first flight could spark renewed interest in winged space travel and help Dream Chaser remain vital to future exploration. Do you think Dream Chaser will launch this year? Let me know yes or no in the comments. Don't forget to like the video and subscribe to get the latest updates on SpaceX and more. The Dream Chaser spacecraft has excited space enthusiasts and people who work in the industry alike. It offers a special blend of sleek design and high performance. Built by Sierra Space, Dream Chaser is a specialized space shuttle designed to carry cargo and, in the future, people to low Earth orbit. It can be launched from a regular rocket and then glided back to Earth for a runway landing. While Dream Chaser is a great design, it has been plagued by delays. Most of these delays have been caused by its launch provider, ULA's Vulcan Centaur. Now, the big question is there a solution for Dream Chaser? The best way forward is for Sierra Space to choose a new, more reliable, ready-to-go launch vehicle. Dream Chaser is built to work with a variety of launch platforms, allowing it to easily switch providers if necessary. The right decision could determine whether the spacecraft will take off or stay on the ground. The best choice is SpaceX's Falcon 9, which is the most launched and reliable rocket in the world today. The Falcon 9 is known for its reliability, frequent launches, and affordability. Partnering with SpaceX could allow Sierra Space to launch Dream Chaser whenever they need to, instead of having to wait behind critical missions like national security payloads. However, we run into a technical problem when it comes to how well the Falcon 9 and Dream Chaser work together. Dream Chaser weighs about 9 tons on its own, but when combined with the Shooting Star cargo module, the total weight is over 14 tons. The Falcon 9 could carry these payloads to low Earth orbit, but it would have to be prepared in a way that uses discarded parts after flight to do so. The main issue is size. Even with its wings closed, the Dream Chaser requires a payload bay 5 meters wide to fit properly. The Falcon 9's fairing has an internal diameter of only 4.6 meters. This means it cannot accommodate the Dream Chaser as currently designed. The total length of the Dream Chaser and its cargo module is 13.6 meters, but the Falcon 9's fairing only provides a usable length of 13.1 meters. Because of this dimensional mismatch, the Falcon 9 is not a suitable choice, even though it would be the best choice for flexibility and reliability. This brings us to the Falcon Heavy, which is a more powerful version of the Falcon 9. While the basic design is the same, the Falcon Heavy typically has better features and has successfully completed more demanding missions. Most importantly, it can accommodate a larger payload fairing, which could be further scaled up to match the size of the Dream Chaser and its Shooting Star module. The Falcon Heavy could be the best rocket for launch, but it doesn't fly as often as the Falcon 9. It offers more flexibility than the Vulcan and has a history of successful flights. Dream Chaser will likely only take off a few times in the near future, so a few Falcon Heavy launches might not be a problem. Partnering with SpaceX for Falcon Heavy launches could give Dream Chaser a real shot at eventually getting to orbit. Another option is Blue Origin's New Glenn. As a partner in the Orbital Reef project, Blue Origin offers a strong teaming advantage. New Glenn is built to carry heavy loads, and its fairing could easily be attached to Dream Chaser. However, New Glenn is in a similar situation to Vulcan. The rocket completed its first test flight earlier this year, but its schedule is still very unclear. The company has a lot of pending contracts with NASA and the military, creating another busy area where Dream Chaser may struggle to get attention. The new proposal is for Sierra Space to buy ULA. This would give them full control of the Vulcan launch platform. This would solve the scheduling issues for the business, but it would create major technical and logistical issues. Sierra Space would need time and skilled people to learn how to use and manage the complex Vulcan system. This would take resources away from what the company is really focused on, which is getting Dream Chaser up and running. Each launch option has its own advantages and disadvantages, but Falcon Heavy seems to be the best choice right now. It provides more flexibility, meets Dream Chaser's physical needs, and has a proven track record of successful flights. Partnering with SpaceX would help Sierra Space and also support NASA's goals by providing a more reliable launch option and a wider variety of spacecraft. Of course, Dream Chaser is still uncertain about its future success. Some wonder if Dream Chaser will have the same problems as Boeing Starliner, which has faced numerous delays and issues with its equipment. But the comparison may not be entirely fair. Dream Chaser has proven to be more reliable during ground testing and development. The spacecraft's design offers several advantages over traditional capsule spacecraft. It can land softly on a runway like an airplane, which is especially useful for bringing back fragile scientific equipment or experiments. It can be easily repaired and reused quickly, making it faster than Dragon's water recovery system or Starliner's parachute landing. Additionally, Dream Chaser's soft landing helps reduce stress on the spacecraft and its cargo. This means it can last longer and carry out more diverse missions. These advantages give Dream Chaser a distinct advantage. If Sierra can fix the launch vehicle's compatibility issues, the spacecraft could quickly become one of the most important assets in the commercial space industry. Its ability to land softly, carry fragile cargo, and eventually transport astronauts makes it a versatile spacecraft with long-term potential. In the future, Dream Chaser could be critical to the ISS and new private space stations like Orbital Reef. The only question is whether everything will fall into place in time to make the most of those opportunities. In short, Dream Chaser's ultimate solution is to find a suitable, reliable, and ready-to-use launch platform. Falcon Heavy is the best choice right now. If Sierra Space can work with SpaceX and work out the last technical issues, Dream Chaser will be able to show what it can really do. The chances of success are slim, but if we make the right choice, the spacecraft could still launch and serve as a new space vehicle for NASA, private companies, and more. Will Dream Chaser finally launch in 2025? That's all for today's episode. See you in the next episode, and thank you all for your support.